The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department vows the immediate cancellation of expelled lawmaker Arnulfo Teves Jr.'s passport once they received a copy of the court order. A Manila court had ordered the DFA on Friday to cancel the passport of Teves, who faces several charges for multiple killings in Negros Oriental. He is also the alleged mastermind behind the assassination of Negros Oriental Governor Roel Degamo. Teves was last traced in Timor-Leste, but the DFA says it will notify embassies across all countries.
Countries where he's in, the cancel may passport. Then it's up to the host country whether they will consider him an illegal alien and arrest him. Kung wala kang extradition figure, what? Hindi pwedeng i-arresto eh. Hindi na yung mga embassies namin. But that is a way na makonsider silang illegal sa ibang bansa kung undocumented sila dahil hindi na-valid yung passport nila.
As for the family of Degamo, they say they will continue to seek for justice nearly a year after the governor's killing.
Lang talagang pinagdadasal na no amount of influence whatsoever can make them, you know, lukewarm or cold in pursuing the justice for our loved ones.
The maritime standoff between Manila and Beijing continues. The Philippine Coast Guard accusing Chinese vessels of conducting dangerous and blocking maneuvers during its 9-day patrol in Scarborough Shoal. BRP Teresa Magbanwa was deployed early February to distribute food packs and safeguard Filipino fishermen in the area. During the patrol, the PCG says it spotted 8 Chinese vessels which had shadowed Manila's ships more than 40 occasions. Another 4 Chinese maritime militia boats were seen in the area. Meanwhile, Beijing counters the accusations, putting the blame on Manila instead. It says China's actions were in accordance with the law to force Philippine vessels to leave its waters. China claims almost the entire South China Sea, ignoring an arbitral ruling which already invalidated its claims. The Philippine Defense Department also going after China. In a statement, the DND said Beijing has no right to comment on Philippine military decisions within its territory. It also urges China to refrain from engaging in what it called provocative rhetoric and activities. This is in response to a warning from China's foreign ministry, which said the Philippines should tread carefully and stop playing with fire by putting troops in Batanes. Philippine Defense Chief Gibo Teodoro earlier called for increased military presence in the province. But for China, the buildup is an issue related to Taiwan. Beijing sees Taiwan as part of its territory under the One China principle. Rising death toll in the Davao de Oro landslide. The number of casualties jumping to 54 after 19 more bodies were recovered Sunday. 63 others remain missing. Hopes are fading for survivors, but rescuers say they will continue search efforts until everyone is accounted for. Thousands of residents have moved to evacuation centers for their safety as bad weather persists.
So ang assurance ng DSWD, by instruction of our President Ferdinand Marcos Jr., masigurado na lahat ng tulong na kakailanganin ng mga local government units natin para mapaglingkuran ng kanilang mga evacuees at mga victims ay ma-provide natin.
Rain has pounded parts of the Davao region on and off for weeks, triggering dozens of landslides and massive floods. Tuesday's landslide buried a bus terminal for employees of a gold mining firm and dozens of nearby houses.